Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, Sig Enforcer, and today we're going to be going over how to mod Star Wars Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2. I have done a video on this already a few years ago, but there's an easier way to get those mods installed, which we'll be going over. And we are also going to implement reshade and a ray tracing global illumination shader by Pascal Glitcher. I do want to give a shout out to General Tantor for the installer for the mods, and also Old Games Reshade for helping me configure reshade for this for the ray tracing global illumination shader, and also forwarding me over a preset too, so that helps out quite a bit. I'll have all the links for all of that down in the description below, as well as links to their YouTube channels. Go ahead and head over there, subscribe, show some love, and we'll go ahead and get started. So first things first, you need to download the game. Obviously I have mine installed through Steam. You can get used through GOG as well. It's fine. This tutorial will still work with that installation method. So once you have that done, we're going to head over to the browser. We want to grab the Jedi Knight Remastered 2.0 installer right here. There's also a icon pack you can download. It's optional. You want to come over to Reshade. You want to download the latest version of Reshade. And then the Pascal Glitcher Patreon page here. You want to be a subscriber or donator for $5 a month in order to gain access to the Ray Tracer Global Illumination Shader. And that will give you access to this section of his Patreon. And then you can access the shader here. So you want to download the latest version of that shader. Also, I'm going to be using Regrade Beta 11. That's the latest for that. And also Physical DOF Beta. That's the latest for that, 0.14. So make sure you grab all three of those. Then we can move over and we can start installing the mods. All right, so here I am at my mods folder. Once you get that Jedi Knight Remastered 2.0 downloaded, go and extract it, double click it, and we're going to run this file right here. It'll bring up an installer for us. And it's pretty professional looking. Go ahead and click next. Next again. I agree. Next. And we need to go ahead and point it to where our Jedi Knight folder is located. So we're going to open that up. I'm going to point it to my F drive, Steam library, Steam apps, common, and then my Jedi Knight folder right here. Okay. Click next and start. And it'll install, and I'll be right back when it's done. All right, guys. So the installation is complete now. So go ahead and click next and then exit. And now we're going to head over to our Jedi Knight folder. All right, guys, so once you're inside your Jedi Knight folder, the first thing we want to do is go to the inject file here, right click it, go to properties, and make sure that it is running the program as an administrator. Once that's done, click OK. And then I'll minimize this, because when you were done with the installer there for the mods, it added these four shortcuts to your desktop. So you've got the game here, a configuration guide, an installation guide, and a configuration file here. We'll get to that in a minute. Go ahead and look through the configuration guide. It's pretty straightforward and simple. I'm going to be going over pretty much everything inside of it, but go ahead and read through it yourself. That way you don't miss anything. And then the configuration here, we're going to right click it, and we're going to edit it with Notepad++. So when you open up the file here, you want to change your resolution. So we want 1920 by 1080. And then if you're going to be using the ray tracing global illumination shader, you want to go ahead and delete all this anti-aliasing here. If you're not, don't worry about it. Just leave it the way that it is. And then we want to move back over to our Jedi Knight folder, because we want to pick an option here. So you have these FOV files. I like FOV 115. That's pretty, it's a pretty good distance modification for the game. It's not too far, it's not too short. As far as being able to see the weapons and whatnot. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to paste it right here. Then when I have that all that done, click save, and we're done with that. And I'm going to bring back up the mod folder here, because there's also another mod that we're going to place in right now, which is the HUD. And all I got to do is copy the gob file, come over to resources, and then paste it right in there, just like that. So now with that done, we're going to go ahead and run the game right now. So once you're in, go ahead and click OK or create a new player if you haven't already. We're going to go to Setup, Display, check Enable 3D Acceleration. Make sure that back buffer and system memory is checked off as well. And this view size here, you want to make sure that it is one tick to the left of max. So make sure you can come all the way to max just like that and back one. And then you're done. And click OK. Click OK. Single player, new game, just to test it out. Make sure it's running well, which it is. So we've got this done. So now all we need to do is we need to install Reshade and configure the ray tracing shader. All right, guys, so I'm back at the Star Wars Jedi Knight folder here. I'm going to back out of my mod folder and move over to my Reshade folder. Reshade 5.2.1, which is what we downloaded earlier. Double click it. We're going to browse, and we're going to browse for our Jedi Knight folder here. Double click it, and you want to select the inject file here. Click open, next, open GL, click next, skip, uncheck all, check all, and then next. And it's going to install all the shaders that we need so we can get this going. And it should be, yeah, it finishes up pretty quickly. And you also have a presets download and a de-input download. So we're going to go ahead and deal with that now. So in the presets, you just double click that, copy the RTGI preset, and then paste it into your Star Wars Jedi Knight directory. And the dinput, copy that dinput.dll file and paste that into your directory as well. And what that file does is it actually allows you to manipulate and change things in the reshade options without moving your character around or shooting your gun or whatever in the game. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to install the ray tracing shader now. So all you're going to do is over here in your Star Wars Jedi Knight folder, click the reshade shaders folder, go in there, and then we're going to open up the ray tracing here. You're going to copy the shaders and textures folders and paste them right there, just like that. I'm going to do the same with the regrade. You're going to copy that shader folder, and we're going to paste it and replace. And the same thing with depth of field here, copy and paste and replace. So now with that complete, we should be good to move back into the game and configure reshade. All right, guys, so we are back into the game. First thing you want to do is click home and skip tutorial here, and then up here click this arrow, and it's going to apply that preset to the game. Now what we need to do is we need to scroll down to display depth here. Check that off, and then we're going to edit global processor definitions. And I had to pull that up real quick. So what we're going to do first is right here, we're going to change this to 413.8. This upside down, the next one, turn that 0 to a 1, and then leave these two. We're going to add a couple. We're going to add reshade underscore depth underscore far underscore plane. And that's going to be 0.1. And add another one. It's going to be reshade underscore depth underscore multiplier. And that's going to be 2.000. And then just click right outside of that. It's going to reload everything. You can click off of the display depth. Scroll back up here. We're going to go to add-ons. Want to make sure you click copy depth buffer. You don't have to copy or click this one. I do just because. And then when you're done with that, click home. And now we have a shine to our gun here. You can see there's reflections on the walls. and the Force. And we've got everything going. Kill these guys real quick.
Get out of my bar. You always cause trouble.
He's just a very rude individual. So with that, we're done. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and hit that like button. Also subscribe and turn that on that bell icon so you know when I upload new videos. And comment down below with any questions or comments that you have, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Later.